This one I am excited about. It's a thermal imaging camera from FLIR. Now you know I like cameras and I've reviewed tons of cameras over the years, but this one's from FLIR. It plugs right into our phone and we're gonna get a thermal imaging camera. Let's jump in and check it out.
Now, massive thanks to FLIR for sending over this review unit. This is the FLIR One Pro. I got the iOS version. They also have a USB version for Android. When you order online, it comes with a backup battery charger as well. Oh, nice, that's so tiny. Look at that. They have this cool feature that you can screw this up or down based upon if you have like maybe a thick case. Now it is charged via USB Type-C. It has an internal battery. I think the life lasts around 45 minutes to an hour. Let's see what else we get in the box. Nice little carrying pouch, I like that. Also includes a USB charging cable. All right, I am crazy excited to get started. Let's go ahead and download their FLIR One app. Now remember, when we plug in the camera, we can face it back at ourselves if we want in selfie mode, we'll call it, or flip it so it's facing outwards. Plug it in. If you need to seat it a little bit tighter or loose, you can just twist that knob. All right, this is gonna be my first time. I don't know why, but I'm just so excited to see this world with thermal imaging. And we got powered on. There it is. Look at that. This is my first time using it. Battery life, top right. Look at that. So it overlays. That's why there's two cameras. We can read the text, then we can see the thermal temperature print. So look at that, it can see the heat. That is so cool. I'm just gonna be saying cool probably 100 times. Okay, this one is pretty nutty. See that little hot spot up there at the corner of the ceiling? Well, that is right where I drilled a few holes to drop down some Ethernet line down the wall. And we're actually able to see where some of that energy loss is, where I pulled back some of that insulation. It is crazy cool. I can seriously see how this would be perfect for contractors, homeowners, or DIYers. Okay, so it's not X-ray vision, but it sure feels like it sometimes. I've been using this thermal camera for a few weeks now. It's educational and entertaining. I've learned a ton, and here's some of the insane things I've been able to capture on this thermal camera. As I drag my hands through the carpet, it's leaving behind a path of heat. This LED lamp, usually cool to the touch, is putting off some heat, and even the electricity flowing through the dimmer switch is glowing warm as well. My iMac Pro's running a little hot, and I can read the temps blowing out of the exhaust vents. This flickering candle is putting off some heat to its surrounding surfaces. We can even spot some of the heat smoking upwards and transferring to my hand. When I fill up my plastic cup with ice and cold water, we can watch it slowly rise and transfer through. I almost feel like a crime scene investigator. Wiping my hand across my t-shirt leaves behind this invisible heat streak. When going outside, the house brick has been soaking in the hot summer sun all day long, and not only can we spot the hot spots, but simply touching the brick with my hand leaves behind a thermal footprint. Watching my little man cub driving his John Deere around, then when he gets out, we can see his heat signature left on the pedal, the seat, and the steering wheel. I was looking at my kitchen island the other night and saw one end glowing super red hot. Turns out that's the effect of the dishwasher running and heating up all the surrounding areas. If we open up the underside cabinet, we can clearly spot the hot water lines, and this thing is just so dang fun and cool. I went out to my garage, and with the insane heat differences, we can see the wood studs through the drywall. When I look at my electrical panel, there's a few fuses glowing more hot than the others, and I'm sure you can guess which is the AC unit and the dishwasher running. Now this one really blew me away. I went back inside to check out the wall directly behind the electrical panel, and as you can see in this normal camera view, this is just a standard white wall. But then when I turned on my Superman X-ray vision, bam, the electrical panel is glowing right through the drywall. This thermal camera would be perfect for so many different contractors. I think of the window and door business, for example. This could be used on both the sales and marketing teams, showcasing before and after installations, energy and cost savings. Here in the bedroom, we can clearly spot the ceiling trusses and the studs through the walls. I pan the camera over to this hand towel, and at first I'm wondering why there's this section of purple. Well, it turns out someone washed and dried off their hands semi-recently, and the cool water was soaked into that towel. I feel like Sherlock Holmes with this thing. Here's my little laser pecker lasering away. Make sure you check out that video in case you missed it.
This is pretty cool. Look at this, is a three-panel light switch. These two are on.
on. Well, these have a hot wire going to it, and this guy is dead, and you can clearly see it on the thermal cam.
So basically, the ideas with this thing are almost limitless. I've researched and learned a ton on how thermal and infrared cameras and technology works, and I probably wouldn't do it justice trying to explain it to you guys. Here's my simplified explanation for you. This way you can determine if it might be a useful tool for your home or work. This One Pro has two cameras built in, one thermal camera and the other is a standard visual camera. This allows us to see both the details like text and image outlines, plus the thermal image layered on top. So can we see through walls and objects? Well, as they say, this camera will show you the temperature differences in the surface of the objects. So generally, no, we can't really see through objects. So if you're looking at an interior wall, for example, the drywall and the stud behind it are approximately the same temperature, well, then you won't be able to see any difference. However, when I look at an exterior facing wall on a hot summer day, my studs and ceiling trusses have a much greater difference in temperature than my insulated cavities. Thus, we're able to see more clearly of those quote unquote invisible objects through the wall. My buddy Kelly suggested that I test and see if I can view my breath or coughing through a mask, which was a cool idea. However, this camera could not see it. However, as I dug into it more, it looks like FLIR actually offers something called optical gas imaging, which is just pretty nutty awesome and really cool in itself. Regarding the key specs and accuracy of this thermal camera, they say it can measure from -20 to 400 degrees Celsius, that's -4 to 752 degrees Fahrenheit. The accuracy is typically within plus or minus 3 degrees Celsius, or 5% difference in ambient and scene temperatures. Video files are recorded at a resolution of 1440 by 1080, and the thermal resolution is 160 by 120.
Okay, this one is gonna be awesome. I have the Smart 8 sleep pod on the bed. I have one cranking cold, one turned way up hot. You think you can see which one it is with this comforter on? Let's pull this back. Dang, look at that. That is so cool. You can see how freezing cold this side is. You can literally see the water grid, the channels through there. And then this is the red hot side. Wow, very, very cool. Again, that is the 8 sleep pod. Made a full review on it. Make sure you check it out. But it's actively heating and cooling your bed with some water channels. So sweet.
The refresh rate of the thermal camera is 8.7 hertz, which is why it sometimes looks a little slow or stuttering frame rate. This slower refresh rate kind of boils down to legalities, trade, and government regulations. A few final notes. If you're needing much longer battery life, well then you can connect the camera to an external battery pack for extended use, which is a nice option to have. Now, I honestly found in all my use cases, the battery never went dead on me. It was sufficiently long enough. The pricing on this One Pro is currently $400, which honestly isn't all that bad for contractors and those in the business space. And they even have this cheaper model I saw called the One Pro LT. It's $100 cheaper, and it has a smaller thermal resolution and less temperature dynamic range. It only reads up to 248 Fahrenheit instead of this one, 752. Might be a viable option if you don't need to take those readings that are super hot. As always, all the product links will be down in the description. If you like this content, consider sticking around. I have some really awesome autonomous drone videos and other fun tech vids posting soon. Thank you so much, guys, and until I see you next week, let's live AuthenTech.